Hey YouTube, it's Hannibal Bonaparte, and I'm gonna bring you guys here a 1v1 Shogun 2 online commentary battle here on the Yamasaki Choke Point map. I am playing against a player who is higher ranked than I am, Khan Asparuk. He is a 10 star, you know, one of those really iconic 10 stars. He has like 600 wins and 100 losses and something outrageous like that, been playing for outrageous amounts of time, and he obviously therefore has a lot more 9 Chevron units than me, and he chooses to take a very hated army, which comprised of Lone Sword Ashigaru, 9 Chevron Lone Sword Ashigaru, and Matchlock Ashigaru, and Bow Warrior Monks. So let's take a look at my forces first. My forces consist of 6 units of unupgraded Yari Cav units, meant to distract and keep his attention on my cavalry. And then I have a unit of loose formation Naginata Samurai here, meant to absorb ammunition, and they have a point in melee defense. 2 units of 8 Chevron No-Dachi here, or 1 9 Chevron No-Dachi and 1 8 Chevron No-Dachi. You can see their statistics there. And then I have 4 units of Katana Samurai with 8 Chevrons for 3 of them and 7 Chevrons for 1 of them. And then, of course, I have my Avatar's Bodyguard with its melee statistics right there. Let's look at my opponent's army here. My opponent, Khan Asparuk, has 5 units of 9 Chevron Lone Sword Ashigaru with various absolutely crazy melee statistics. And then he has 3 units of Matchlock Ashigaru behind them. 3 units of bows. 2 of them are bow warrior monks. 9 Chevron, of course, with 200 range. One of them is a 9 Chevron Bow Ashigaru. And then he has a unit of Bow Cavalry with 2 Chevrons, his Avatar's Bodyguard, which is a famous bowman, and a he's got Great Guard, 9 Chevron in this forest, and Light Cavalry in this forest as well, and a Great Guard with 9 Chevron over here that just popped out, and is going to catch my Yari Cav right here that got a little bit too close to his Matchlocks, as you can see. So, first things first, he's straying far too far ahead with his Avatar's Bodyguard, so I am going to catch my opponent's Avatar's Bodyguard here and make him pay for that mistake with my Yari Cavalry units here, and I'm going to absolutely decimate his flag. You can see it's shredding already. Over here, I plowed into his Great Guard from the front, and now I'm going to hit it from the side with my other 2 units of Yari Cav, and over here, his Great Guard has absolutely mopped the floor with my Yari Cav units. And I'm just simply trying to capture this dojo here and get my Naginata Samurai closer to the action. Over on this flank, you can see that his Avatar's Bodyguard is now down to a mere 12 men. My Yari Cav still have 33 men, and his Avatar's Bodyguard, you can see there, it has some good melee statistics, actually. He's a journeyman swordsman, which means that he's put a lot of points in melee attack, melee defense, but he doesn't have the armor, and he doesn't have the charge or stuff like that, the morale that that my general has, my friend here Ruse knows that I'm making a video, so basically you could see that my Yari Cav here did get decimated by his Great Guard. You can see his Light Cavalry right there with 1 Chevron routing. His Great Guard is also very wounded, so my Yari Cav did do a number there, but in the end his Great Guard won. But that was merely to serve as distraction. You can see here, I'm now going to charge downhill at his Great Guard, try and kill these guys off. He foolishly turns away and tries to run away, which is going to allow me to take a few more kills here from his Great Guard unit. And my Yari Cav is not meant to win this. He has the numerical advantage as well as the extreme qualitative advantage. He's bringing in some Yari Ashigaru to support. I'm bringing in my Naginata Samurai to support. So all I wanted to do here was catch his Great Guard for long enough for my Great Guard to get close enough to, my Naginata Samurai to get close enough to do their damage as my only spear units. It is always good to bring some spear units to your army to counterbalance your opponent's Cav. So you can see here that I have some units coming back from routing there. That's a Yari Cav unit, so I'm going to bring them closer. I also had this unit of Yari Cav come back from routing, so I dismounted them in order to take the shrine so that I could take my melee infantry units off of this hill. My opponent has set up so as to take the sword dojo here, and he's set up in a formation that most people find extremely annoying, which is they've put their he's put his Matchlocks behind his line. Now, I'm not trying to slam my opponent or anything, but this battle was really a a textbook example of the playing that people are leaving Shogun 2 for. A lot of people find this behavior that my opponent is exhibiting to be extremely annoying, and it's wrecking the game. But I think it's fine, because in the end, strategy always beats, you know, the junkie, you know. Strategy wins. So you can see here that I'm just chasing his units off, and I'm going to pull back my cav when they get too close to his matchlocks. But I managed to destroy his Yayashigaru. Sorry, someone is trying to talk to me. I destroyed his Yayashigaru in this river crossing here. So now I'm going to push my melee infantry units across over here. He's now sending both of his 9 Chevron Great Guard in against my Yard Cav units. That's a good idea by him. But in the end, if you look at my melee statistics for my avatar, he's got 27 melee attack, 19 morale, 18 melee defense, 35 charge bonus. The only category in which this Great Guard beats me is the charge, and that's not a gigantic deal. But, I mean, I have much, far superior melee statistics than 9 Chevron Great Guard in my avatar's bodyguard. Plus, here you can see that his units are getting killed over here by my Yari Samurai, or dismounted Yari Cav. And eventually what I'll do is I'll hammer an anvil. He will route my Yari Cav there, which will cause me a little bit of, it was a little bit annoying, because then I had to actually dismount my avatar to claim the shrine, because it's not mine yet. In the end, what it's going to come down to is the melee fight here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to begin my advance with my Naginata Samurai, and he's going to start shooting at them. And Naginata Samurai are excellent for this sort of meat shielding, because they have very good armor. But even still, it's taking some pretty heavy casualties on its march up. But because my opponent, of course, has like these 9 Chevron Bow Warrior Monks, Bow Ashigaru, and 3 units of Matchlock Ashigaru, one of which he's placed very nicely up here on this hill. And it will begin firing sometime very soon, down into the ranks of my Naginata Samurai. These guys will actually start to waver. And now he's going to get some shots in on my No-Dachi. Some of these do get blocked by this hill right here, so I was very fortunate about the terrain. And I'm going to get a downhill Banzai charge into his Lone Swords here, and it knocks them flying to the ground. And his Lone Swords... Now, if you remember at the beginning of the battle, what happened is he was foolish with his general, which allowed me to kill his general. And what that shows you is that now these Lone Swords, although they are 9 Chevrons and they have these absolutely outstanding melee statistics, this one has 19 attack, this one has 25 attack, 25 attack, 19 attack, and just all kinds of crazy attack statistics and defense statistics, they do have poor morale. If you notice that these Lone Sword Ashigaru have 6 morale, whereas my No-Dachi have 11 morale, and my Katana Samurai have 12 morale. And as soon as I capture the shrine, they'll have even higher morale. Although I do cancel the shrine because I feel that my avatar is in need. You can see that I've gotten in here against his Lone Sword Ashigaru. His Lone Sword Ashigaru are putting up a very big fight against me. But in the end, it won't really matter because they've already just absolutely been creamed in morale. I do lose this unit of No-Dachi. That's what sends my avatar's bodyguard over. But this unit of Naginata Samurai comes back, so that's all good. And right there, I managed to destroy his infantry resistance on this flank, and pretty much a mass rout is going to go on here. You can see all the white flags turning up. So now the name of the game is get into his Matchlock Ashigaru. I've already completed that over here. I missed this bit of action. Here's the remnants of my Yari Cav fleeing, but I managed to turn around here, charge, rout a unit of Bow Ashigaru somewhere in here, and I routed that unit of Matchlock Ashigaru, wavered one of his Yari Ashigaru there, and did a lot of damage to his miscellaneous units in this area. So that was a very good charge by me. And then I managed to get into more of his Matchlocks over there. You can see his units routing off there. And basically what this is, why this mass rout is happening, is his poor morale of the Lone Swords and the Matchlocks. Pretty much his entire army, besides his Bow Warrior Monks, and his cavalry were Ashigaru units. And you can see now that that was a big mistake. Fortunately for him, a lot of his units in this area start to come back from routing. You'll be able to see that pretty soon. But he does manage to keep some Bow Ashigaru there. He keeps both the Matchlock Ashigaru and the Lone Sword Ashigaru there. This unit of Lone Swords come back. I'm not sure if that Matchlock... that Matchlock comes back. But I have the overwhelming infantry advantage at this point, and my general here is just running down these Matchlocks so that these guys don't come back. And pretty soon here they're going to shatter. Shatter having been done massive damage. And you can see that I'm just chopping away at these last units. This Yari Ashigara is unupgraded, and it has only a mere morale of 5. And it's taking massive casualties very quickly. It's going down extraordinarily rapidly. And my units have racked up some pretty impressive kills at this point throughout them. 108 kills there. My avatar actually gets a massive amount of kills in this battle. But it's got to do a little bit more work first. You can see here what I'm going to do is I'm going to charge my Naginata Samurai into this Lone Sword Ashigara unit. And I'm going to hammer and anvil it with this unit of Katana Samurai. I was going to try and sneak past and kill that unit of Matchlock Ashigara, but when I saw that this Lone Sword was wavering, I decided to turn back and hammer and anvil it. And now I'm going to go after the Matchlock Ashigara here. And I'm going to get in there and I'm going to start to attack the Matchlock Ashigara. And my Nagakata Samurai did rout, so he's going to sandwich my Katana Samurai, but the poor morale of these Matchlocks, a mere 5. These guys will not stand out, even though they have the hill advantage. Definitely won't stand out to my, 7 Chevron Katana Samurai unit. And I think that one, in fact, it's already got 170 kills, and it will go up to the 8 Chevron rank very soon here. And it did go up to 8 Chevrons in the battle. So you can see that his unit of Matchlock Ashigara shattered. So I'm going to ignore his Lone Sword Ashigara and just charge right into the next one. And I'm going to take my other Katana Samurai units, and these guys can continue the fight on against his Lone Sword Ashigara in this region here. And you can see some of the heavy melee action going on in there. You can see that, pound for pound, pound for pound, his Lone Swords are very tough. But, if you look at the individual interactions, his Lone Swords are probably winning that. But because of the poor morale, the unit as a whole will rout. And there he's trying to get his Matchlocks away, but I'm going to continue following them because even if my Katana Samurai routes, I'd gladly trade a Katana Samurai for a Matchlock Ashigara, especially if that Matchlock Ashigara is the last one, and it was the last one. So now he doesn't have any morale shock units. And in this end game, pretty much right here, as you can see, I've only got 2 units of Katana Samurai left, both with a mere 28 men there, 23 men there, and 42 men there, plus my Avatar's bodyguard. Morale matters a lot in this. So I'm going to just manage to stop his units from firing here. That's all I really want to do. Make his units do as little damage as they possibly can. Let's see if I can find my Avatar's bodyguard. Oh, there he is. Catch up to him. And he's going to now launch a hammer and anvil against the Lone Swords, which is going to rout them. But in the end, basically, you can see all of his units here managed to rout because of the poor morale of the Ashigara units. So, and he just has this, bow cav that I said good game at this point, but now he's going to try and play cat and mouse game, where he thinks that his bow cav is the cat, and my Avatar's bodyguard is the mouse, but in the end it turns out that my Avatar's bodyguard is the tiger, and his is the lowly tabby cat. So, basically what this battle showed was that the hated 9 Chevron Lone Sword Ashigaru and Matchlock Ashigaru spams, although your opponent can bring more numbers, you have the unstoppable morale on your side. So the enemy armies that bring these absolutely outstandingly cheap, costing, and powerful Ashigaru builds, all you really need to do is rely heavily on shock. You need to flame. You need to turn on the flaming arrows. You need to turn on the whistling arrows. You need to hammer and anvil, war cry, anything that affects morale, do it. If you think that your opponent might bring an Ashigara, Lone Sword Ashigara spam, then bring retainers that hurt his morale, because that's really how you're going to win the battle, by taking advantage of your opponent's poor morale. And remember, my opponent was higher ranked than I am. I just checked his ranking here today, and I fought this battle today. He is higher ranked than I am. He's one of the very, he's probably one of the earliest 10 stars. He's a very supposedly good player, but, it doesn't really matter, because skill is skill, and he didn't play very skilled in this battle, and in the end, I managed to take advantage of the morale. So, I want to say good game to him, and I hope you guys enjoyed the battle, and I hope you guys learned a lesson from it of how to defeat the Lone Sword Ashigara and Matchlock spam.